Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God, hallelujah, Jesus, glory to God, Father, I thank you, hallelujah, glory, thank you for nature itself, Father, thank you, God, thank you just for nature itself, Father, hallelujah, glory to God, thank you for nature itself, to God be the glory, to God be the glory. I just want to bless the Lord, hallelujah, he's worthy of all the praise, and it's been a minute since God allowed me to just do something live and just get into the atmosphere and get into nature. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm blessing the Lord, even though it's not cold, but it's a little mild, and I bless the Lord in the midst of it that I'm able to give God the glory. I want to say good afternoon to each and every one of you. Hallelujah, who has been supportive of what God has been doing through me, the ministry, and I always want to give back. I always want to give back to each one of you, and I do not take it lightly. I do not take your friendship, your partnership lightly, and I just give God the glory because in the midst of what we're going through within the world itself, it's so many different things that is going on, so you can't really just pinpoint one thing. But in the midst of it, God is still in control. He's still in control, and I can say it like that because he's omnipotent God, and omnipotent means he has all power. Hallelujah, Jesus, to God be the glory. And I also bless him because, you know, he's omnipresent God. He's everywhere at the same time. And he's omniscient God. He's an all-knowing God. He knows all. He sees all. He hears all. Nothing escapes him. Hallelujah. And as I'm sitting out here in nature, every now and then a cool breeze will come through. And that lets me understand and know that the Spirit of the Lord is with me. The Spirit of the Lord is here on earth. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. And I give God the glory because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And those that believe on Jesus Christ shall not perish, but have everlasting life. But I'm not going to stay before you that long. I just want to go ahead and just release what has been burning in my spirit for the last 2 days. And it kept, God kept, Holy Spirit kept taking me to, I kept hearing in this spirit, let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, no matter what you're in the midst of, let not your heart be troubled. And a lot of times we say this, and a lot of times we say it at funerals, homegoing celebrations, but there's a meaning behind let not your heart be troubled. First, let me go ahead and identify the scripture, and then I'm going to release a prayer into the atmosphere. It's coming from John chapter 14, verse 1. And it says, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. And what Jesus was establishing was that he was a teacher at that particular time. He was the blueprint. He was that instrument that God was about to use. Hallelujah. Let me go ahead and release a word over this, prayer over this. Father, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, God, I give you glory, honor, and praise. And I thank you for this word that has been burning in my spirit for 2 days now, that somebody needed to hear this. Somebody needed to know that let not your heart be troubled. So, Father, I thank you right now that I've literally moved out of the way and you have stepped forth. I have decreased and you have increased. Father, I thank you right now that your word just went forth unchecked by any outside force. And I'm believing right now in the name of Jesus, it will fall on deaf ears and dry places in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Okay, I bless the Lord because a lot of people are fearful. A lot of people is falling away from their faith. A lot of people is dealing with all different things on every side. I want you to understand, as identified on last year, God gave me the revelation to my church that we often identify demons and as spirits, and they are spirits, hallelujah, but what spirit are you talking about? There's a demon of frustration. There's a demon of aggravation. There's a demon of a worration. There's a demon of stress. There's a demon of hallelujah, of depression, oppression. Those are demons. And Jesus allowed us to understand that, you know, it's John 14:1, and it's in red letters. That means Jesus or either God is speaking. Hallelujah, Jesus. It says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. So God allowed Jesus to come into the world to be that blueprint, that mouthpiece, that instrument that he was going to show his glory. Because oftentimes Jesus said, you know, God, I do this and I bring glory to your name, for it's all about the glory of God. But it also allows me to know, it says, let not, I can stop. It says that particular scripture really means that he has commanded us control over our hearts. God is literally commanded through Jesus Christ. He commanded us to have control over our hearts. Hallelujah, Jesus. And in the midst of this, I got to give God the glory, because a lot of us are dealing with, well, the main thing, the biggest topic right now is COVID-19, coronavirus, cancer, and but there's a lot of other entities that is affecting human life. You got dealing with car accidents. You're dealing with sickness on every side. You're dealing with senseless killings, hallelujah, that, you know, that the enemy wants to inflict on us. But God, Jesus allowed us to know, as he was only speaking of what his Father allowed him to speak, let not your heart be troubled. Still, you want to understand why, and let not your heart be troubled. Let's go from scriptures, because it says, let not, and that let not, and I stopped right at not. Hallelujah. Not took me to verse 27 of John 14. 27 says, peace. This is what Jesus says. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth. Give unto you. Hallelujah. Not as the world give unto you. He says, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. First and foremost, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but love, power, and a sound power, love, and a sound mind. So that particular scripture, verse 27, that verse took me to Philippians. Philippians 4:7, and I'll let the Holy Spirit do what he do. Hallelujah. Philippians 4:7 says, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Let me read that again. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. He didn't just say your heart, but your mind as well. He said, I'll keep your heart and your mind in the midst of chaos, in the midst of everything that's going on around you. He said, I'll keep your heart and your mind. So that lets me understand and know that when Jesus spoke, that God was in control, and God is still in control. Here it is. I'm out in nature, and the birds are chirping. The birds are going from one tree to the next. The leaves are still green. The limbs are still living. So that lets me understand and know that whatever is going on in the world, it ain't bigger than God, because I serve a true and living God. So I will give God all the glory. If you want to flood the timelines of Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, why don't you just say, my God is awesome. My God is real. My God is bigger than anything that I could ever face. Hallelujah. My God is bigger than my financial struggles. Matter of fact, God said, I don't need you to be struggling, because your daddy is the richest man that ever lived. So why are we sitting here? Yes, we in the world system. Why are we sitting here accepting things that we wasn't even meant to carry? Our dad is the richest man that ever lived. Yes, we in the world system, but I know that I'm a believer and I operate in the kingdom system. I literally operate in the kingdom system. I'm not Democratic and I'm not Republican. I operate in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. So see, the kingdom of God is royalty. The kingdom of God is majesty. The kingdom of God is the most powerful kingdom in the world. The kingdom of God is the most powerful kingdom in the world. Matter of fact, the kingdom of God has the most powerful army in the world. Hallelujah, Jesus. You say, well, what you talking about with the most powerful army? We got apostles. We got prophets. We got evangelists. We got pastors. We got teachers. That's the fivefold ministry. That's to edify the body of Christ. That's to edify the church. Hallelujah. So in the midst of it, I know a lot of us are going through different things and we have lost a lot of loved ones, you know, last year and still losing a lot of loved ones. But you can't pinpoint it on just one thing. There's so many things going on in the world. Hallelujah. You can say sickness. You can deal with poverty. You can deal with violence. You can deal with all these different things. But I want you to understand, we're the most powerful kingdom on earth, the body of Christ. We are the most powerful kingdom on earth. And I can go ahead and take you back to Black Panther. That was a powerful nation. I'm just using an analogy. That was a powerful nation that was basically hidden out. But I'm telling you that the body of Christ has to rise up with the fire of the Holy Ghost. We can flood the timelines with all these different COVID-19, cancer, killing and all this. Why not flood the timelines with this? Flood the timeline with the Bible. And I know y'all say my Bible or look, but that means I use my Bible. Flood the timelines with the Word of God. If you flood the timelines with the blood with the Word of God, you're gonna see a shift. You're gonna see a change. And even if you flood the timelines, matter of fact, if you flood the timelines with Jesus, you're gonna see a change. And I don't understand why are you going to put a name that's causing poverty and sickness and all of this over the name above all names, which is the name of Jesus. See, sometimes you just got to say, not sometimes, all the time, Jesus. I'm tired of looking at TV. Every time I turn on my TV, I'm looking at, or every time I hear something on the radio, it's something concerning a name that I don't even care releasing no more. Because I release the name of Jesus. I release the name of God Almighty. He's the great I am. I release the name of the Holy Spirit. I release from Genesis the revelation because I understand that there's power in the Word of God. There's power in the Word of God. And you can say, well, how you know there's power in the Word? Because I'm sitting out here. The leaves are still green. The birds are flying from place to place. I even hear them chirping and even the squirrels. I don't see the birds falling out the sky. I don't see the trees withering up. I don't see dead animals. So what that lets me understand and know that this is a spiritual demon. Hallelujah, that's going on within the world. But I know through the word of God. He said, let not your heart be troubled. Why are you sitting there worrying? That Jesus said it's going to be trials and tribulations. But he's giving you a weapon of mass destruction. The word, faith, the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. He's giving you the word, faith, and the Holy Ghost. Some say the Holy Spirit. Either one. Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit. And he's giving you a tool within your mind or in your heart to believe. Why not believe? I get a lot of calls about people, dealing with this particular disease. This particular person got killing a car accident or this particular person dealing with, you know, a senseless killing. But I'm believing right now in the name of Jesus that through all of this, hallelujah, through all of this, hallelujah, we got to know that God is real. And I was speaking to my mother, and I'm going to let it go earlier. And she was allowing me to know that. And I, you know, I told her, you know, what's going on? A lot of people are going through things and they are hurting. And you know what she brought to my attention? She said, because a lot of people have a lot on their heart. They're carrying jealousy. They're carrying envious. They're carrying fear, first and foremost. They're carrying fear. They're carrying anxiety. They're carrying all these different things that will cause a domino effect within your body. Hallelujah. See, fear will cause sickness. But how do you fight fear? With faith and the word of God. The Bible already said. The Bible literally already said, I'm not giving you the spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. But a power, and I can go to Luke 10:19 says, Jesus told him, he says, behold, I've given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And by no means they will be able to harm you. He said, by no means they will be able to harm you. He said, I've given you power, love. Love is 3:16, John 3:16. God so loved the world. He so loved the world. He loves his creation that he gave us a gift. He gave us. That's why at Christmas time, we're giving presents, but what's the real gift? That's why a lot of times people say, what's Jesus is the reason for the season. He gave his only begotten son. He so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And for those that believe, here comes believe again, for those that take him at his word, for those that believe on Jesus Christ, there shall be miracles, signs, and wonders. Miracles, signs, and wonders. Hallelujah, Jesus. So he says, for those that love the world, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And for those that believe on him, shall not perish. So why are we sitting here worrying if he says shall not perish? Perish being dead, going away. He said, those that believe on Jesus Christ shall not perish. But what the next thing he says, but have. Sometimes you got to say, but God experience. But have everlasting life. But have everlasting life. Hallelujah. So in the midst of a pandemic, I see the trees, the limbs, still are green. They're still living. Hallelujah. The birds are chirping. The sky is still there. And I'm breathing. I don't even have on a mask. I'm breathing because without the trees, if that was so powerful, the trees would be dying. But the trees, God has given us everything we need. The trees gives off the oxygen that we need. Hallelujah, Jesus. See, sometimes you got to just go outside and take that mask off. Take that mask off and say, you know what? Let me breathe in the fresh air. Let me breathe in God. Because he's a spirit. He's a spirit. And he moves through the wind. You can't see the wind, but you can feel the wind. Hallelujah. So I'm blessing the Lord because in the midst of this, there's glory after this. There's glory after this. There is literally glory after this. So for those ones that has fallen away from your faith because they say the church doors is closed and everybody have an assignment from God, but I know Supernatural Praise Ministries, our assignment is the doors are still open. And the Bible says, forsake not the assembly. Hallelujah. That means we're supposed to come together. You don't think God is going to protect us in his house? when he can protect us in Walmart, Dollar General, or Piggly Wiggly, or the department store, or McDonald's? You don't think God? And it's crazy how the devil will try to distract you, how the devil will try to confuse you. He'll let you go any, you can go anywhere else, but when it comes to the church, oh, y'all can't go in that confined space. But you're in Walmart and you're not, they're not even social distancing in Walmart. They're not even social distancing in the fast food restaurants. So you mean to tell me I trust being out there and not trust God? Come on now. I'm just keeping it real. God allowed me to see these different things. And I know that this particular thing is going to be over. And I speak this into the atmosphere because God can blow it away right now if he want to. But then in the midst of it, he wants everybody to wake up. It's time to wake up. Wake up. I'm not telling you, go wash your hands like you're supposed to. Wash your hands. Take care of your hygiene. I'm not telling you to be ignorant to Satan's devices. But I'm telling you, don't leave God out. You can't leave him out. Don't leave Jesus out. I don't know why people want to leave Jesus out. Oh, Jesus is the name above all names. Jesus came that we will have life and have it more abundantly. John 10:10 says, but a thief cometh but to steal, kill, and destroy. It's talking about the devil. So the devil wants you to be blind. He still wants you to be asleep. The devil don't want you to go out and test the air, the fresh air. He don't want you to go out and say, oh, you know what? If the tree is still living, that means I still can live because the trees are giving off oxygen. God put all these different things in place. He put it in place that we will utilize it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Whose report are you going to believe? I'm going to believe God's report. You can't leave Jesus out because Jesus, God used Jesus to show us how to live. To show us how to live godly. Does that make us perfect? No, not by a long shot. Not by a long shot, but we are perfect in God. We are the righteousness of God. So I'm not going to let nobody tell me my worth. And I know that my dad is the richest man that ever lived. Hallelujah. And that's God himself. And he has so many names. Most High God, Yahweh, all these different names. Almighty God, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Shammah, El Shaddai. Hallelujah, Jesus. So I'm not here to beat nobody up, but I'm just here to let you know that God wants you to wake up and open your eyes. And know, open your eyes to his word. Open your eyes to the faith that he's given into each one of us. Every born-again believer has a measure of faith. So I just wanted to come today and just kind of encourage you. Even if you feel like you're falling away from your faith, pick up your word. Even if you feel like you want to give up and throw in the towel, don't give up and throw in the towel. Throw in the bloodstained banner. And say, you know what, Lord, I can look back over my life from years now and see what you have done for me. I can look back from last week when I didn't know how I was going to make it. And here I am. And I can even look back from last year when I had so many family members that passed away because of this particular entity. Hallelujah, Jesus. That, you know, I didn't know how I was going to make it. But you know what? The song says, I'm not going to sing the whole thing. It says, I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. Yes, he did. Through it all, I made it through. When I couldn't see my way, I made it through. When they even talked about you, I made it through. When they didn't understand you, I made it through. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. When they conspired against you, I made it through. When the devil came in and tried to sniff you out like wheat, I made it through. That moment that I had of frustration, I made it through. When he canceled out worryation, I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. Yes, he did. Through it all. Anybody can testify and say, I made it through another day's journey. Your journey could be from last year to now. Your journey could be from even this morning to now. I made it through. When I lost my child in that car accident, I made it through. When I lost my mother and my father, I made it through. When I lost my sibling, I made it through. When I lost my coworker, I made it through. When I didn't have no money in my pocket, I made it through. Another day's journey. God kept me here. Yes, he did. And that's why I can say, through it all, I made it through because of God. I made it through because Jesus sits on the right hand of the Father. I made it through when I couldn't keep myself because the Holy Spirit is my keeper. I made it through. Hallelujah. All I had was the word, and I stood on the word. I made it through. All I had was my faith, and that's all I need because Jesus is the author and the finisher of my faith. I made it through. I begin to call those things that be not as though they were. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me here. Yes, he did. Yes, he did. Yes, he did. He kept you when you couldn't keep yourself. He kept you. Glory to God. Glory to God. So the next time that you're feeling discouraged and you want to give up and you're falling away from your faith, sometimes you just got to say, you know what? I'm going to step on the outside. I'm going to take this mask off and I'm going to sit and I want to see if I can breathe some fresh air. Because see, this is the air that God blew on you earlier this morning. He blew that ruha breath on you. What is the ruha? The ruha is the breath of life. That's what it is. The ruha is the breath of life. I bless the Lord for each and every one of you, and I thank you for always supporting me, the Supernatural Praise Ministries. I'm excited for what God is about to do. You're going to see a heavy dose of what God is doing through me and through my church family, through my family, through the ministry itself. I bless the Lord for all my partners out there. All the partners of the Supernatural Praise Ministry, I thank you for your partnership. I thank you for what you do on a daily basis, on a regular. Hallelujah. I bless the Lord for my members. I bless the Lord for my family. I bless the Lord for all the men and women of God. Hallelujah. That's coming together as one body. Hallelujah. How can two walk together except they agree? But I'm believing right now that the church is rising up. And see, I want you to understand it. I'm going to leave this right there. The church, the body of Christ, we are the most powerful kingdom. We are the most powerful kingdom on earth. Y'all might not have never looked at it like that. I tell you, I don't get into politics. I'm not a Democrat and I'm not a Republican. I am a member of the kingdom. I am a member of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I'm a member of the kingdom of God. My daddy sits on the throne. And my big brother Jesus, who I'm joint heirs to, he sits on the right hand of the Father. And God sent his spirit, who is roaming the earth with me right now. He's my keeper, the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. He is the Paracletus. He aids me, he assists me, he guides me, he teaches me. Glory to God. So I bless the Lord for the Trinity. I bless the Lord for the help, the Holy. I bless the Lord for the angels that has been put in place. I bless the Lord for the word of God from Genesis to Revelation. I bless the Lord for the faith, the mustard seed faith and the measure of faith. I bless the Lord for the ability to believe. And most of all, I bless him to have a heart to believe. So that's why I'm not going to let my heart be troubled. I refuse to let my heart be troubled. No matter all I've been through and maybe all of what you've been through, you can't let your heart be troubled. It's a command. John 14:1, let not your heart be troubled. Jesus was commanding us to let not your heart be troubled. So I bless the Lord for each and every one of you. And we're going to do our normal countdown. We don't wait till December the 31st, 12:01 to say, I'm not even saying Happy New Year, Happy New Beginning. New beginning. Hallelujah. New beginning. It's a new beginning when he wakes us up in the morning, because every morning he gives us a new mercy. Every morning he gives us new mercy. Every time he blow his ruach breath in us, we become a living soul. Hallelujah. So we're going to do a countdown. Everybody right now, hit your emojis. Go crazy with your emojis. We're going to start off with 60 seconds. Hallelujah. Everybody hit your emojis right now. It's to edify the body. It's to edify the church. It's to glorify God. It's to bring glory to his name. Come on, everybody, right now. Hallelujah. We got about 50 seconds. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. Give God everything you got. Hallelujah. Come on, give him everything you got. Give him everything you got right now. Glory in him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Bless you right now, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. We glory in you. We got about 42 seconds. Come on. Come on, everybody, right now. Come on. It's a new beginning. It's going to be a new beginning. See, a new beginning, a new start. All grace abound toward you. Come on, come on, everybody, right now. Come on, let's give God the glory. Let's do his name. We got about 32 seconds. Come on, come on, everybody, right now. Give him everything you got right now. A new beginning. We don't have to wait to December the 31st, 12:01. It's a new beginning. Hallelujah. It's a new beginning right now. Hallelujah. We got about 21 seconds. Hallelujah. 21 seconds. Come on, come on, come on, come on. We can do this, y'all. We can bring glory to God's name. We can bring glory to God's name right now. Hallelujah. We got about 17, 16, 15. Oh, come on, come on. We can do better than that. Hallelujah. See, 13, 12. 12 represent the 12 tribes. Hallelujah. 11, 10. Hallelujah. See, 9. Hallelujah. See, 8. 8 represents new beginning. 8 represents new beginning. Hallelujah. See, 7. 7 is the number of completion. It's perfect number. Come on, come on. 6. Whatsoever you ask according to his will shall be established. How can two walk together except they agree? 1. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. New beginning. New beginning. Come on, go crazy with the emojis. New beginning. New beginning. New beginning. New beginning. New beginning. My day. This is a new beginning. Then this, I start a new hour, a new beginning. My body is healed. My mind is healed. I got money in my bank account. I got a place to lay my head. Hallelujah. See, I give God the glory because he's a spirit, and we must serve him in spirit and in truth. We must serve him in spirit and in truth. He's a spirit. Jesus laid out the blueprint for us. Hallelujah. He laid out the blueprint for us. Hallelujah. And he left his name. There's power in the name of Jesus. Everybody who got all this crazy stuff on Facebook, flood the timelines with Jesus. Flood the timelines with the Bible, the Word. Flood the timelines with the Word. You'll see a shift. Not just any shift, but a paradigm shift. Another dimension. Another dimension. New beginning. New beginning. And you know what? Hallelujah. Because just because y'all are tuning in and coming in agreement, God said, I'm going to give you 100-fold back. Because what you're sowing, and I need each and every one of you to sow this video, share this video. I'm not asking you for no money. I'm asking you to sow this video because somebody needs to understand. Hallelujah. It's not over yet. Hallelujah. See, and I want you to, matter of fact, I want to tell you right now, Jesus, we already won. We already won. We already won. No brainer. We already won. We already won, y'all. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I give him the glory, honor, and praise. Share this video. Not about no likes or none of that. It's about somebody that has fallen away from their faith. And they need to be encouraged today. Somebody today that wanted to give up and throw in the towel. this video could be a blessing to them today, because it was talking about let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. God got this. I promise you, He got this. He got this. Truth be told, all of us should have been gone. But because of His grace and His mercy, we're here. I bless the Lord for each and every one of you. I normally don't just come and do a live unless God sent me, and I don't do it. Matter of fact, I don't do it. God sent me. It was burning for 3 days. And He said, I need you to go on the outside and demonstrate to the people as Jesus did. I want you to let them see the trees. Now, next time, if they weren't paying attention, the trees, the leaves are still green. The trees are still alive. The birds are still flying. Deers are still walking. Squirrels are still moving. If this thing was so powerful, wow, that's crazy. If this thing was so powerful, why God didn't take the trees from us? Trees give off oxygen. Stop walking around all day long and all night long and not, God just wants you to step on the outside and say, you know what? I want to breathe some fresh air. You walking on the outside, you sitting on the outside of your patio, and you got a mask on for what? For what? Man, the trees, your house is surrounded by trees, and the trees giving off fresh oxygen. Oh, glory to God. See, those masks is designed to stop the regeneration inside of us. You can't keep those masks on all day long. I understand. Don't be ignorant now. You're going in a public place, then yeah, okay, wear your mask. But sometimes you need to, when you get home, say, you know what, I'm going out and I'm going to get some fresh air today. I'm going to go in my backyard or go in my front yard or go on my patio, and I'm going to just breathe in some good oxygen. I'm not going to wait till they send me to the hospital to get that oxygen that's not natural. I'm talking about this oxygen from off the trees, y'all. and besides that, the birds and all these, they will give you peace. If you sit back and you're breathing in oxygen, and then the peaceful sound of the birds chirping. Every now and you might, if you're living in a place with a lot of forest, you might see a deer or rabbit or, but it brings peace to your soul to let you understand that God is still alive. He's still the creator. He's still the creator of heaven and earth. So let not your heart be troubled, because He commanded us that. He commanded us that. Listen, do me a favor and share this video. It's not about me. It's only to bring glory to God's name. That somebody will be encouraged today. That somebody that wanted to give up didn't give up. Because now they can understand, they can go to John chapter 14, verse 1 and say, you know what? It says, let not your heart be troubled. And then you can go to verse 27 when it confirms the fact that He said, I'll keep your heart in your mind. Then you can go to Philippians 4 and 7. It says, I will give you peace that passes all man's understanding. Then you can go to John 10 and 10. And when it reminds you that the devil don't have no power. The thief cometh but to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I came that you will have life and have it more abundantly. Amen. So to God be the glory. I bless the Lord for each and every one of us. Release a prayer over you. Father, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, I lift up your people today, God. I thank you in advance for what you're about to do in their lives. I thank you that they will believe on Jesus Christ, that there will be miracles, signs, and wonders that they will see, that they will see the evidence according to Hebrews 11 and 1. Now faith is a substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. And let them stand on your word, Father. Let them stand on this word from Genesis to Revelation, according to Isaiah 55:11, that my word, your word, Father, your word will go out of your mouth, and it shall accomplish what we please it to do. And it will not and shall not return into its void. Father, I thank you right now. And as I close with our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Let us all say amen, amen, and amen. God bless each and every one of you. God smile upon you. And listen, I love you with the love of God. And ain't nothing you can do about it but love me back. God bless your family. Remember to share this video. Someone is in need of a word today. God bless you.